So in my last video, I ended off doing some bandos with a team, and we're going to do that today as well. But what I want to do meanwhile waiting is I want to train my combat stats up a bit, because we are actually going to get me a whip before going to bandos, hopefully, unless the RNG for Max Nick is terrible on the Abyssal Demons. So I'm going to be doing some Slayer, because it is very good to get herbs anyways for my 70 herb lore grind that I need. And I'm doing farm runs meanwhile doing Slayer. So let's see what the first assignment we can get is. Black Demons, that is not that bad. Slayer level coming in, just hit 66 Slayer, 51,000 experience to 67. And after that, what task are we going to get from Neve? Fire Giants, that's not bad. And that is the Fire Giant task done. I hit 78 strength on that, and the herbs actually from this task was surprisingly good. This is some nice herb lore experience, but let's get a new task. Ooh, another Black Demon task. I think I will have to skip that actually. I want to get to 400 points though, because I want to unlock the Slayer helmet, because I have the Black Mask now. This is actually mine before I was borrowing. Aberrant Spectres, that is perfect. Actually, a task I really wanted. That is a lot of herb lore experience. Man, I wish I had a herb sack. Unfortunately, I don't, but this is from 23 kill counts. Insane amounts of herbs. I mean, you know what? Instead of having to bank all the time, I might as well actually just go to Tithe Farm and get the herb sack. I mean, we have stamina potions now, and I can do the medium level fruits, so the farming experience is not going to be terrible, and it shouldn't take too long, so let's go and do it. 100 fruit the first time, and I actually didn't use a single stamina potion though, so I don't even need this, which is very nice, might be because of the graceful. Let's see how many points and experience we get. We need 350 points. And of course, farming experience is just great, because I need 70 anyways for Song of the Elves. And we get how much? 21,000 experience and 26 points. So I will have to do this like 15 times over. Oh, that's 68 farming. Oh, it's only 250? Okay, so that's even faster. I'm only going to have to do that 9 more times at this point. Going to be getting 69 farming here, which means that I am 100% going to get 70 farming on this grind, which is the requirement I need for Song of the Elves, so that is very convenient. And that means, most likely in this video, I will be able to get all the requirements done for Song of the Elves. So Max Nick is currently killing Abyssal Demons, and he is using Ancients, and that is of course very rune costly. And as soon as he gets the last, aka 4th whip, we are going to Bandle. So I'm going to give him all of these runes to help him out on that. Should be enough for hopefully the whip. And this is going to be 70 farming from those fruits, so we are now done with farming for Song of the Elves, but we still need some more points to be done with Tithe Farm. And there it is. I was actually even talking about him maybe not coming for the Bandos trip, because he wanted to get that last whip. But there it is. We now have 4 whips, and that means I am, by the way, currently at like 200. Okay, I'm at 206 points, so I'm very close to the herb sack. But we're now going on a detour to do some bandos. I already did some content on bandos in my last video, so I'm actually just going to show the highlights this time. Oh, that's a new one, I think, right?
Oh, bog.
Wait, we had the we had Godsword Shard 1 before, so that's another one. One more to go, and then bandos hilt.
So we just need Godsword Shard 3, right?
Yep.
No way.
Yeah. It does the same effect, yeah, I know what you're saying.
Because like
oh no way!
Oh my god.
Bandos hit!
Wow.
That's the best drop we could have got almost,
that's
right?
That's the best drop. Yeah,
oh
that's
my
the best
god.
Drop.
So wait, we only need shard 3 then, right?
That's yes, raids, yeah. Just need
oh
shard
my
3.
God. Oh my that's, god.
That's raids ready.
Nice, dude.
Holy.
See the chat there? Oh, look at the chat in the
oh
game.
Oh my
yeah.
god.
Wait for the stream.
Oh my god,
lag.
I was about to die because I was like looking at the hilt.
Holy fuck, boys. And then you would then take the planks to your house, make them, and then...
Oh! No way!
Oh, dude.
That's huge!
Oh, my... Wait, that's like... That's literally like 20 kills later, or 15.
Now we have 2 spec weapons. Alright, we're gonna grind Seraph.
Well, I guess we have to get more shards.
You gotta grind Seraph me to get all the shards.
Yeah, oh my god, 2 hills.
Oh, that's the one!
Oh shit!
Oh my god!
We got a Godsword!
Oh my god.
I was baiting you guys.
Yo, let's go!
You were baiting? He was actually baiting!
Yes! I was little baiting you guys.
You thought, why did you think that I was talking about yours?
So confused. Is that your bait? I was so confused.
I think Dovidus thought I was getting excited over his bait, but I was
yes.
We got it. That's actually the one we
for me, that was so weird, right? Because I saw the 3. And I was like, oh, cool, we got it. And then I saw the two on the floor, and I was like, wait, did I get a two as well?
I was so confused as well, holy shit. Well, 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 what a Bandos trip that was. I went to bed after that, and that is why I have the morning voice right now. But we are back to the Tithe farm to finish off all the points and also 71 farming. But now we can buy the herb sack. I don't know if I mentioned what it does. It basically just allows you to store 30 of each herb inside of it. So, of course, I have to type this in, but what it does is that, yeah, you can store like 30 Raynars, 30 Dwarfweeds, 30 Irids all at once. You can stack so many herbs into it, so that is going to give my Aberrant Spectre task a lot more convenience to them. So let's go ahead and buy it. That is now the herb sack, of course, a collection log item as well. But before we go back to the Aberrant Spectres, I'm actually going to use all of the potions I have in the bank. I just want to see how close I can get to 70 herb lore. So this is all the potions that I made. I still have some Carantine potions and some Haralander potions, but I do not have the secondaries. But I got 218,000 experience and I am currently level 69. So I'm going to pick up where I ended my Slayer grind, and I'm going to collect some more herbs with my herb sack, and hopefully we should get enough herbs kind of in the near future to get that 70 herb lore. I really just want to get into Priftinas, get it done with Song of the Elves, and I managed to squeeze out some more herb lore experience. I need 47,000 left, and I am doing herb runs, but I'm going to at the same time, even off task, just farm Aberrant Spectres for the last herbs, because we have no herbs as a team, because we fed basically everything to Dark World Order to get Saradomin brews, but I think it shouldn't be that much of a grind, to be honest. Oh, and by the way, I am trying to hit 15k subscribers by the end of the year. That would be the dream for me, so if you want to help me with that, make sure to subscribe, but only do so if you like my content. Oh my god, this is perfect! Look at this! I got a genie when I only had 1.9k herb lore experience left to 70. Let's get this, and I'm actually 690 experience, and now we are going to get some dragon scales and make the first magic potions or whatever this is. No, antifires, of course. And that should be enough for me to get 70 herb lore. And here we go. This is going to be it for 70 herb lore. The last four potions, and then after this, there we go. Now I just have to get 70 mining, and we have everything done for Song of the Elves. The next clip is 70 mining, and then it is Song of the Elves. It has been quite a grind, I would say, to get all the 70s, because I had to do most of it myself. Of course, the smithing grind, I got help with the money for the gold ore, but other than that, I did pretty much everything on my own. And that is going to be the last skill I had to get, 70 mining, so let's now complete Song of the Elves. Ah, there we go, that is the library done. It was actually not that bad. The first time I did it, it was with a YouTube guide, and it took like 1.5 hours. This time I timed it, it says 42 minutes. So Runelite, the quest plugin, is just lovely. Oh my god, is this it? Oh, there it is. Woo, that was like a 10-minute fight. I actually died twice as well. I just brought like only Saradomin brews and restores, and that turned out to not be the best thing, because then my attacks were just... I mean, I basically didn't get enough DPS in because I had to brew to full HP, because how the boss works is that there will be a moment where the boss hits you for your entire HP except one. So you need to make sure you're on full HP. If you're not at that HP, well, then you're going to get one shot. And I did die like that once. I tried to like spam brews to get to that stage, but then I couldn't really DPS. So yeah, the best way to do it was definitely bring a mix of like sea turtles and Saradomin brews. And of course, blood blitz to keep up my HP, so I didn't have to use that much food. But, wow, finally, that is the completion of Song of the Elves, which I will get in just a sec here. First time entering the Elf City, let's see that quest completion screen. It is nice to have this done. Look at the experience as well. 20k in all the skills that you needed to have to complete the quest. Let's see that in the chat as well. Song of the Elves is now completed. I can do the Corrupted Gauntlet, the normal gauntlet of course. I can do Solcano. If I get my thieving up, I can thieve from the elves here. And if I get my agility higher, I can use the Priftina's agility course. Also, we have access to the Crystal Chest, which is you turn crystal keys into crystal, the better versions of the crystal key, and then you use it on a chest in here. So yeah, this is going to be very interesting to use. The first thing I want to do is complete a normal gauntlet. I can't enter the corrupted before I complete one of the normal ones, but the normal ones are pretty easy. The most extremely simple way to explain the gauntlet is you basically spawn in this dungeon. Here in the end is the boss, and you have basically a certain time. You can see on the top left here I have 8 minutes and 15 seconds left to actually get enough gear, food and potions and everything to be able to kill the boss. If you die on the boss, you get terrible reward. If you kill it, you get the good reward basically. So now I have some gear and a weapon, a tier 3 magic weapon, which is the highest you can get, and a tier 3 ranged weapon, also some prayer potion, and basically a full inventory of food. I can drop these crystal shards. And why you need two different types of weapons is because the boss will start praying against what you're using. So after a certain amount of attacks, I can actually go in here and show you guys. When I attack now with magic, it is going to start praying versus magic in a few attacks. Also, it will start spawning these tiles on the ground. When they are yellow, you cannot stand in them. And if you do, you're going to get destroyed. So there you can see, now I have to change to ranged instead. And that is the boss defeated. Now the corrupted version, which is a lot harder than this, is basically the same thing, but it is just way harder. Like the last boss is hitting a lot more, you have less time to prepare, everything is just way harder. So that is what I'm going to mostly do, but let's see what the reward for the normal one was. Yeah, that's not that bad. And that is the first corrupted gauntlet kill. I actually did not manage to get it recorded because I was actually focusing really hard on completing that, because it was very, very difficult. With my stats, it is pretty hard to complete it. But let's see what the first corrupted gauntlet loot is going to be for the account. And it is some average rune drops, but definitely not bad. And now we also have this Fashionscape corrupted gauntlet cape. I am definitely going to do a lot more of the corrupted gauntlet, but I also want to do some Solcano just to show off the boss. It is a skilling boss, and it's a very chill skilling boss in my opinion, and you ideally want to be like 3 or 4 people in one world, and I was just hopping basically until I found a world with only 2 players in it, because that is the way you get the best reward. So you basically just mine these rock formations that it's pointing to, you smith them in this furnace, then you runecraft them here, and when you have these, just go into the blue one and you throw it at the boss, and then it goes down at 0% or 0 HP, and then you get to mine it. And this is precisely why this boss is so insane to do. 230 mithril bars in one single drop. Yeah, it's pretty busted for Iron Man smithing, I have to say. I honestly had a very hard time finding a world where there were 3 people or 2 people in the session that needed another one, so I just decided to go to the Solcano world. It is definitely going to be a bit less loot every time, but it is going to be very reliable and fast kill, so it should be fine. So I just wanted to do a couple of kills for the video, and this is going to be kill number 20, and all the loot I've got is in my inventory right now. So you can see how good this boss is. I did some in masses and I did some in 4-man. And let's actually have a look at how much value this is. So I'm going to put everything in and take out the sharks. Almost 2 million on a main account. And of course the adamant bars, like 52 of those are 520 adamant darts. And also 184 adamant ore, which you can also of course turn into bars. So really nice. But that is going to do it for this video. I am so hyped to get into stuff in Priftina's, mostly corrupted gauntlets. And maybe if we're really lucky in the near future, we can get one of those crystal weapon seeds for the bow of Feradin or the blade of Seldor. But that is going to be it for this video. Hope you guys did enjoy it. And I'll see you in the next one, guys. Take care.